Welcome to the FINE lecture series. On behalf of the Perinatology Research Branch of NICHD and the National Institutes of Health, my name is Lami Yeo and I am one of the developers of FINE. This lecture is an introduction to why congenital heart disease is important. The purpose of this presentation is to provide background on the importance of congenital heart disease, explain why sonographic examination of the fetal heart is necessary, and discuss why congenital heart disease is the most difficult of all congenital anomalies to diagnose prenatally. Congenital heart disease is an important healthcare priority because it is the most common birth defect and the leading cause of infant mortality related to birth defects. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, or the CDC, notes that congenital heart defects are common, costly, and critical conditions that affect people throughout their lives. Every 15 minutes, a baby is born with a congenital heart defect in the United States. In 2013, hospital costs exceeded $6 billion to care for children with congenital heart defects. The CDC estimates that more than 2.4 million U.S. children and adults are living with cardiac defects. And finally, about 20 to 30% of people with congenital heart defects have other physical problems or problems with achieving skills, learning, or understanding. Why should sonographic examinations of the fetal heart be performed in all pregnancies? Since up to 90% of cases of cardiac defects occur in pregnancies without high-risk features, this provides the impetus to perform a comprehensive screening examination of the fetal heart in all women to maximize the detection of congenital heart disease before birth. Therefore, these exams are performed in pregnancy as part of routine care, and specific sonographic cardiac views are recommended. Moreover, scientific reports have shown that the prenatal detection of specific cardiac anomalies improves the pre-surgical condition and mortality rate, survival after surgery, and long-term neurocognitive function and outcome. The prenatal detection of congenital heart disease may improve the outcome of fetuses with specific cardiac lesions, such as transposition of the great arteries, hypoplastic left heart syndrome, and coarctation of the aorta. So an important question is, during pregnancy, how well do we detect congenital heart disease in the fetus? The answer, unfortunately, is that overall there is a poor detection rate worldwide. Prenatal ultrasound overall only detects 15 to 39% of all cases with congenital heart defects, and therefore this is a serious issue. Over the last 20 years, the prenatal detection of congenital heart disease has not markedly improved despite better equipment, improved imaging techniques, and intense training for fetal sonographers. The detection rates still remain low. Unfortunately, structural cardiac defects are among the most frequently missed abnormalities during prenatal sonography, and therefore this is an important cause of medical legal liability. It is well known that they are the most difficult of all congenital anomalies to diagnose prenatally. Why is this the case? The first is size. This is the fetal heart at 20 weeks of gestation, a typical time when pregnant women undergo a prenatal ultrasound examination. Yet note that the heart is only the size of a U.S. nickel. The second reason is that the anatomy of the heart is complex, and this is evident in the next three slides. This slide shows the fetal cardiac anatomy from anterior to posterior. From the top of the heart to the bottom, and from one lateral side to the other. Yet the most important factor affecting the prenatal detection of congenital heart disease is the skill and expertise of the sonologist. Therefore, in conclusion, congenital heart disease is an important condition. Sonographic examinations of the fetal heart are necessary to perform in pregnancy. And congenital heart disease is the most difficult of all congenital anomalies to diagnose prenatally. Thank you for your attention.